A general characteristic of Vietnamese is the perception that dementia is a mental illness. And in fact, some of the Vietnamese words that caregivers have used to explain dementia, which I'll run through shortly, are variations of crazy. And unfortunately, Vietnamese culture continues to attach stigma to mental illness, which could lead to families not seeking help because they're embarrassed. Also remember that one of the cultural beliefs about illness equates living a good life with having good health. So there may be the thought that family or the elder brought the dementia upon themselves due to their karma or their behaviors. So even if the caregiving responsibilities become too taxing, families and caregivers are disinclined to use outside help or nursing homes or residential care homes until they can absolutely no longer manage and there is no one left in the family structure willing and able to do so. You'll find that even if the means are in place to access the nursing homes, that the family will likely be more interested in using subsidized home care. So if they have Medi-Cal, you'll find them asking about in-home supportive services rather than the skilled nursing facilities. I'd like to mention that one of the differences I've started noticing is the increased willingness of the younger generation to use institutional care. It appears that the family members and caregivers who are born in the States or are recent immigrants from the People's Republic of Vietnam are less adverse to the use of nursing homes and placement for long-term care, whereas the older, more traditional people from the first and second immigration waves continue to view outside care and nursing homes with more disdain and attach more moral judgments to it. I haven't seen any studies on that, but that's what I've been noticing, and it would be interesting if somebody were to take that on. In addition to cultural factors affecting help seeking among Vietnamese, there are the practical issues of being unable to communicate effectively with service providers. Also, not knowing about available services either because of language barriers or the service community, perhaps not doing enough outreach. For instance, government services such as Medicaid are generally known within the community, but non-federal services such as respite programs or emergency financial funds are not widely advertised and therefore underutilized for the non-English fluent population. However, when informed of the services, families and caregivers tend to be willing to make use of what is available, especially regarding things like transportation, home care, or financial assistance, and especially if the cost is affordable or federally subsidized. And if you're a clinician working in a medical setting, what you may experience in working with the Vietnamese population is that they probably won't make use of your expertise until there's a sentinel event or the elder's symptoms have become problematic, in which case your primary mode of intervention and opportunities to provide resources and information to the family will be through triage social workers and doctors. And speaking anecdotally here, because as far as I'm aware, again, there's no published numbers on the use of clinic and emergency services among Vietnamese, but what we're generally seeing in the clinic and medical setting are patients being admitted for management of severe dementia behaviors related to violence, failure to thrive, and help being introduced as a result of the family seeking medical assistance for those problematic behaviors. I think you'll have a sharper appreciation of how Vietnamese perceive dementia as we go over the Vietnamese words commonly used to speak of dementia. The word demented, for instance, is defined in the Vietnamese dictionaries as boi roi vi la lang, which translated into English means mixed up and entangled because of worry and anxiety. Interestingly, dementia is defined in Vietnamese not as an illness, but as a symptom. Literally, it translates as a symptom of a lost mind or lost intellect. Lang chi means blurred or loss of intellect, and mut chi is loss of intelligence or intellect. Lan lon means to be confused or mixed up. When caregivers sought medical help and were given formal diagnoses of dementia, they also used terms such as be fail out or fail now to explain the illness, which means brain atrophy in Vietnamese. On the other end of the spectrum, we have caregivers and family members who believed that their care recipient was spiritually possessed or that the spirit had been caused to wander off due to stress or possession, and therefore use terms like be mut hon or nyap hon. And unlike in Western society, where calling someone crazy is usually a lighthearted interaction, you know, if somebody says, you're just nuts or you're crazy, among Vietnamese, it's a rather seriously derogatory remark. And yet we've had family members and some of the younger caregivers interviewed refer to their care recipients as Điên rồi or Bà khùng rồi, meaning he's become crazy or she's crazy now.